Hey guys, my name is Claire and I make videos about international students wanting to come here and study here in Canada. For this video, I'll be sharing a wonderful news and opportunity for aspiring international students, especially for Filipinos. So I came across this college that's giving out 10,000 grants specifically and exclusively for Filipinos. And also I'll be sharing some things to consider when choosing your school here in Canada. So ayan, to answer the question, to answer one of the most asked questions, is there an available scholarship for us international students? The answer would be yes. So the school that I would be focusing in this video is none other than Ascenda School of Management. So Ascenda College is currently located at downtown Vancouver. And as you've seen in the title, they're currently giving out $10,000 Canadian dollars to Filipinos. So this will be available for upcoming Filipino students who will be registering in January and April 2021 intake. I'll talk more about this in the later video. But first, I just wanted to share some things to consider in choosing your school. You know, as we all know, one of the hardest things to consider, or like one of the trickiest things to think about when you're first applying for your student visa, is choosing your school. It's like there's a lot of choices out there and you feel so overwhelmed. And sometimes we get discouraged because it's like you don't really know where to start. But don't lose hope and don't give up just yet. Let me try to help you guys out like in considering or like what factors to think about when choosing your school. So the first thing that I'd suggest is to eliminate some of those schools that are like some of the choices that you have right now by verifying whether or not they're included in the DLI list. So DLI means Designated Learning Institution. You could find that in this website. I'll be linking that on the description box below, but I'll also guide you on how to do that in this video. So basically what this means is that schools that are found in this list are eligible for PGWP. Now, if you're not at all like familiar with PGWP, it means Postgraduate Work Permit. So it's basically a work permit granting you to work for at least 3 years. So if like one of your future goals is to stay here in Canada as a permanent resident or even have a Canadian citizenship, so you have to make sure that your chosen school is included in that DLI list, because there's a lot of like schools out there that's not on the list. So you really have to be, you know, you really have to make sure about that. And the great thing is that Ascenda College is eligible for PGWP. So right now I'll be guiding you through the DLI list that I've included in the description box below. So we're here now, and if you search the name of the school and if you see it there, then that means your school is eligible for PGWP. If you search in Ascenda College, you'll see that right there. And that means it's eligible for PGWP. So I'm pretty sure if you're looking at your list right now, there's a couple in there that's not on the list. So cross that out if I were you. So another thing that you want to consider is look into the programs that your desired school is offering. So currently at Ascenda College, we're offering plenty of programs and choices, such as Bachelor's of Hospitality Management and Bachelor's of Business Administration, which they offer in 5 specialized fields, such as Accounting, International Business Management, General Business Management, Human Resources Management, and Marketing Management. So you have to think about what you want to take and make sure that particular school is offering that particular program that you want. So the third one is the number of academic terms in a specific school. So this basically depends on every school. Mostly you'll see that most schools have this 2-semester kind of thing in an academic year. So it's like 6 months, 6 months in an academic year. Also, you will find some that has trimester system, which is what I went through. But Ascenda College has the possibility to start 4 times a year. So that means they have January, April, July, and October in a year. So each academic cycle or quarter can take a minimum of 9 credits, and that's equivalent for 3 courses, with which all students can work up to 20 hours a week during their studies and 40 hours per week during academic break or per quarter. Personally, I feel like this is a great option to consider, especially because if your application got delayed, then that means you have to defer your intake, right? So some students, if their current chosen school only have like trimester or even like 2 semesters in an academic year, so then they would have no choice but to defer their intake. They would really have no choice but to wait for like another 5 months or even 3 months. And sometimes that's just really not the best idea to go. It's just wasting time for me. So it's a great thing actually for me, yeah, to be able to have that flexibility. Okay, and the next thing is, you know how sometimes we get discouraged when we see this very interesting school and you look at the requirements and you realize that the admission process is just too complicated for you. So you move on to the next school and you look again and you look again until you get tired of like looking for school. Well, I totally get you because I've been there, I've done that. But don't get discouraged just yet because there's a lot of school, like Ascenda College, that has the smoothest and fastest admission process. Did you know that they only require just few things from you guys? They only require a copy of valid passport, application form, a copy of your transcript, how they do their own evaluation. There's no need to go through credential evaluation like WES or WES. I don't know what that stands for. And this is another great news for you guys because they have waived any English proficiency requirement. So that means you are no longer required to provide that English proficiency language test or whatever, like IELTS, TOEFL, like Duolingo, that kind of stuff. You're only required to provide that if you do not have any university degree or you have graduated more than 10 years. I know this is a great news for you guys because I know how you're feeling about IELTS and all that kind of English proficiency test because I've been there and believe me, I was really scared when I took my IELTS exam. And I know that it can be time consuming. If you're not confident enough, you have to do your review, which is what I did before. Actually, I did my review for a month. And then I also paid, I think I paid for more than 10,000 to take the test. And I know you're scared because what if you failed and then you have to take another exam and then pay another more than 10,000 pesos. So I know that this is such a great news for you guys. So yeah. And another thing is Ascenda College has a credit transfer system. So I'm pretty sure if you're a college graduate back in the Philippines, you're asking yourself whether it is possible that your university credit back in the Philippines could be transferred here in Canada. And the answer is yes. Ascenda College has a credit transfer system. So if you do that, it could reduce your courses that you have to take to finish college as little as 2 years. So after the transfer of credits, as little as 2 years, you could have your Canadian degree here at Ascenda College. And last but not the least, scholarship availability. Yay! This is my favorite part to share with you guys. Personally, talaga, if I knew that there was this kind of like school that offers this kind of great opportunity for international students, I would probably take it. I'm happy to extend this great news for you guys. So Ascenda College is currently offering $10,000 Canadian. So this is exclusive for Filipinos wanting to take or register through January and April 2021 intake. So yeah, this is available for us Filipinos. So definitely think about it. Definitely consider Ascenda College. So the students from the Philippines will receive it and it will be applied as a 1,000 tuition fee grant per term, starting from the second term. So just think about the money that you're gonna save. So instead of spending that 10,000 tuition fee for your tuition, I mean, you could use that for rent or like your everyday expenses, your monthly expenses. So think about it that way. And not just that, they're also giving out $500 early grant for all January 2021 students. And this is also different from $10,000 Canadian that I mentioned earlier. And there's another one. One of my favorite grants from them is this. The $600 grant to purchase a laptop. I wish I had this opportunity back when I was still studying. I could really use this kind of help before. I really wanted to buy a new laptop, but then I just don't have that much fund before. And this will be very beneficial to you guys, especially for those of you who does not have a laptop at this moment and are just planning to buy one when you guys get here or, you know. So yeah, I feel like this is such a big help for us, especially in these times of, you know, online studying and stuff. You really have to have your own laptop. All you have to do is submit a laptop purchase subsidy program application form along with proof of purchase or the purchase receipt and the name of the student. So yeah, Ascenda School of Management is currently located at downtown Vancouver. After your school, you guys could go out, do the touristy thing, hang out with your friends. Of course, not right now because of the coronavirus, but like, there's a lot of opportunity for you guys. Also, the public transport is very accessible. And also, if you guys want me to do a campus tour for Ascenda College, do let me know. Leave a comment down below and I'll see what I can do for you guys. So that's it, you guys. I know I have been, you know, talking a lot in this video, but I hope you learned a thing or two that would really mean so much to me. That would really, really make me happy. Hopefully you guys will consider Ascenda College. If you guys have any other concerns that I was not able to address in this video, don't hesitate to email Santiago. He's currently the coordinator for this kind of program. I will be linking his email and also leaving some other details about their school on the description box below. So if you guys are all interested, email them. They will get back to you real soon. But yeah, I'll see you guys on my next video. Please don't forget to like, share this video if you guys haven't, and we'll meet again. Bye!